Hello, ladies and gentlemen, dear viewers. Welcome back to your first English TV show. This is now what we call Ucad Leadership TV show. And today it's with a real pleasure and an honor for me to be with some of my cohorts and my teammates who are around today. And we are around in order to talk about a very common issue, a very specific issue on which we are going to debate on today. But before that, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to present to you some of my teammates, my cohorts, as I said it a while. They are here around in order to debate on the given topic, which is extremely important. And today, ladies and gentlemen, we are talking about youth facing high technologies. And we'll be dealing with the advantages and with the risks, and for sure we are going to give you some solutions. So guys, the first one that I'm going to give the floor is a very lovable brother, a very gentle brother who's been doing a lot for Ucad Leadership TV show. First, let me give the floor to my brother, Mr. Musa. How are you?
I'm fine.
Hope that you are doing well.
I'm great.
What about the holidays?
Great, I'm enjoying it very well.
It's going well?
Nice, very nice.
Wonderful. So ladies and gentlemen, time for Mr. Musa to present himself.
Okay, hello and welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to our first show. As you probably know, I'm very excited to be here with you guys to share with you this very recent topic, which is youth facing technology. And we're gonna be dealing with the advantages and the risks. And after that, I wish that this is going to be a very highly interactive and participative work. And thank you again.
Brother Musa, very nice words, I'm telling you. So this is Mr. Musa. I'm from Cheikh anta University, student in license 3. And it's with a real pleasure and honor for me to receive him right over here as my teammate and as my cohort. So next, I'm going to give the floor to my lovely sister Mariam. Right? Can you please give me a... How are you?
I'm fine.
Hope that you are doing well.
Yeah.
What about the holidays?
Everything is okay.
Can you please let us know who you are?
Hi everyone, the name is Mariam Diop, student at Cheikh anta University at the English department, and I'm also a member of Ucad Leadership TV show. And that's a big pleasure for me to be here with you. As you already know, our today's topic is youth facing high technologies, risks and advantages. So keep on watching and you will see something amazing.
I like that. Very nice presentation, I'm telling you. Very nice presentation. So without losing time, we are going to welcome Sister Zahara. How are you?
I'm doing good.
Very beautiful as usual.
Thank you.
How about your holidays?
It's nice. I'm enjoying.
You're going well?
Yeah, I'm doing good.
Please, present
okay.
yourself.
Dear member of LTSU, dear lovers of English language, dear viewers, good morning. I am Fatima Zahra, a presenter of Leadership TV show Ucad. Today, I'm very honored to be here with you sharing the theme of you facing high technology, risk and advantages. Just to tell you that today you will enjoy a lot with us. Thank you so much.
Very nice, very nice. Ladies and gentlemen, dear viewers, just to remind you that you are watching Ucad Leadership TV show. And today I'm here with some of my team workers, some of my cohorts. And today we are dealing with a very important and specific topic, which is about you facing new technologies, right? And then as you all may know, it's a very common issue on which, frankly speaking, that has always been the talk of the town. Every God's given day, from Monday to Sunday, from dawn to twilight, people are talking about that. And until now, we haven't yet found any consensus regarding that issue. And today, I and my teammates, exactly, we are going to show you that this is, how things should work when it comes to what we call technology. And by the way, I'm saying hi to all of our team, because as you may know, Ucad Leadership TV presenters are very numerous. And unfortunately, we did not have the opportunity to welcome them over here, all of them, right? Because some of them, they are a little bit far from Dakar. But anyway, by the way, I'm telling hi to all of them. And from them, I would like to mention, a very gentle teacher, a very lovely teacher who has really helped us in order to initiate that very important initiative. And that one is Mr. Mar, our teacher. Frankly, we're saying hi. Hope that you are doing great. So from now on, without losing time, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to give the floor to my brother, Mr. Musasi. So Musa, today we are talking about youth facing technologies. So when we were talking about technologies, what is the first thing that comes to your mind?
Okay, thanks for giving me the floor again. I just want to make something clear to the listeners. When we are saying about technologies, some people might automatically think it is African technology. You see that Africa has been, for a long time, we have many people who really, who were architecture, and they were creator, and they created many things. I'm not talking about on that way, but here we are talking about the new world, the new technologies. It is a very current issue, a very current issue in the recent decades. We are facing technology, and it is something very spread nowadays with the internet, with social networks, and things relating to that. And what we have to know is technology has revolutionized. It has revolutionized for some decades, but it also facilitates the long distance communications, and it is just an area that has happened in the recent decades. So technology has many advantages and many risks, I mean the drawbacks. So the advantages are more tremendous than the risks, but anyway, we created the internet, we created things like that, but even we created things like that, we have to face the same problem because we are the source of inspiration of these things.
Very good. Thank you very much, Mr. Musa. I think just later on, we are going to welcome you again in order to develop your idea, because you said something very important, which is that we are having much more advantages in internet rather than disadvantages.
Of course.
Hope you'll be coming later in order to develop your ideas about that. And by the way, ladies and gentlemen, your today's host is Muhammadu Mustafa Jang, student at Cheikh anta diop University in License 3. So now on, I'm going to give the floor to my friend Mariam. Right?
Yes.
So Mariam, whenever we talk about technologies, what is the first thing that comes to your mind? What do you automatically think about?
Yes, when we talk about technology, we are talking about something that is very, very important because it's a part and parcel of our lives. And we just have to know at first that technologies and the human life cannot be separated. We cannot separate it. So as we know, technology is something really important, and you know,
nobody can live without that, because nowadays people are connected, you know, they are connected, and whatever they might do, they need to get in touch with internet, they need to be involved in new technologies in order
yes.
to make it improve.
Yes, you're right, because even in, you know, with the internet, you know, it facilitated us, you know, our communication and stuff like that. If you want to communicate with someone who is, you know, down USA or you know in every part of the world, you will do it easily, you know, without any problem. And I think that's something you know really important and amazing.
I'm telling you, that's very important. You're definitely right. I'm telling you, very, frankly speaking, what you've said is quite right. So dear viewers, now let's give the floor to Mrs. Zahara.
Thank you for giving me the floor. I will just start where she ends, because I think that technology has left from luxury to necessity.
Yeah.
Now, it's not a luxury. Thank you so much. Now, it's not a luxury to have technology, but we need it in our day-to-day life. You know, because since world has changed, man has done his best to change with it. This is the reason why we need technologies. I think so. Thank you.
Very good idea. Dear viewers, I hope you really appreciate my guest today, because right now they have been talking about the importance of technologies. I mean, the how we cannot live without technology, and it is a very common issue, and that's why today Ucad Leadership TV show has decided to choose technology as our today's topic. And for sure you guys are going to enjoy it, because we'll be telling you a lot of things, you know, related to that very common issue, which is about technology. But now we're not talking about technology, you know, in a very general point, but we're saying you've facing new technologies, meaning we focus a lot on youth, right? Because they are, I mean, they're much more concerned rather than the other ones. I mean, elders or our forefathers and foremothers, you know? Because most of the time, that's youth who are really involved in technologies. Everything they do, they really think that they cannot achieve it without technology. And it is something understandable. And a while, my friend Musa has mentioned something that is extremely important, saying that technology is not about internet. You know, it's not about social media. It's a very long term, I'm telling you. It's a very big one, something that is really, I mean, widespread. So that's not only what we think about, because whenever we talk about technology, the first thing that most of the time comes to your mind is all about, I mean, the internet or those stuff. But let me tell you that technology is far much bigger than that. It's not only that, but it's bigger than that. It's more like wider than what we think. It's beyond our ideas. And today, ladies and gentlemen, with Ucad Leadership TV show, you are going to discover a lot concerning technology, right? So from now on, I'm going to give the floor back to Mr. Musa, right? Musa, I will be asking you a very important question. I mean, dealing with advantages in a professional and a social world.
Okay, thank you for the question. The advantages in the professional and social world, as you probably say, when we are talking about technology, we're not referring to the internet, not to social network or things like that. But it is, yeah, okay, it is more extended than what we think. First, not in the professional world, but in the social world. But in the professional world, we need the technology. And if I say we need the technology, what I mean inside is the internet, the application we can use, the softwares, the internet and social network. For example, if you take the case of WhatsApp, okay, it is used every day. So you can't see a young boy or a young girl with a certain age and without having WhatsApp on her or on his phone. It is impossible because it will facilitate the communication, the connectivity with other people. And also we have the technology in the social world. The social world, I mean, if you take the social networks, Instagram, Twitter, and internet, you see, it will make easy to communicate easily. Because, as I said, technology has made a kind of revolution. It has made a kind of revolution in the past, in the recent decades.
What we probably call new technology.
Okay, new technology, information and communication. Okay, this is very, very precious. This is very tremendous. Okay, so what we have here is the youth, the way that they use technology, and if I say that, they may not be concerned to the business way how they use application for business. No, but the social networks. I mean the interaction. Interaction with the other people, because they use internet, they watch a video, they post their photo, and I mean, if I say they post their photo, the most beautiful photos. For example, for the girls, they can make makeup, they change their appearance, and post it to the internet, okay? And application that are used for chatting, okay? So we can say that if you ask a youth a question, what technology is for, they can tell you that it is for communication. But it is far from being that. Even the government needs some technological tool to proceed to their work. Even the president. Okay? Because the president, it needs it to better secure its privacy, its private informations.
All right.
You see? And there are many aspects, even in transportation, okay, here is the new cars. It is relating to technologies, because the new cars are very smart car. If you say smartphones, we can say also smart cars. Because here, nowadays, when you fix a car, it is like you are fixing a mobile phone. Because there are many adaptations with the cars. You can sometime drive a car without touching the bar.
Sure.
Okay? You can make a kind of going backward without touching anything. And the car may also have a kind of a screen. You can see what is happening outside the car.
Oh.
Yes.
All right.
Okay? So this is in transportation mode, but it also with the GPS and the mapping. You can't be lost. If you want to go somewhere, you have just to locate yourself to know exactly where you are. Even your phone is lost, you can find it back. It is possible.
All thanks to technology.
All thanks to technology. And it is also thanks to the science.
Come on.
Okay.
Extremely important.
Okay.
Thank you very much, Brother Musa C, one of our co-hosts today with Ucad Leadership TV show. So ladies and gentlemen, dear viewers, just to remind you that you are watching Ucad Leadership TV show. And our today's topic is you facing new technologies. And our show will be divided into three parts. First, we'll be talking about the advantages, and that's what we're doing right now. And we have noticed that technology has become something compulsory, something obligatory in our day-to-day life, right? And then the second part, we'll be talking about the disadvantages, because most of the time when you're living in a community, whenever you have disadvantages, for sure you'll be having some drawbacks, some disadvantages, I mean some risk. And we will have to talk about that. And then last but not least, we are going to propose you some solution regarding the disadvantages that we have in what we call technology, or what we call internet, which is one field in technology. And for now on, I'm going to give the floor to Mariam, and she's going also to focus again about the advantages of what we call the new technology.
Yes, but at first I just want to tell you that technology is the application of scientific knowledge for practical purposes. It is something that can help people to make things easier or even to solve their problems. And that's the reason why people use it to travel, to learn, to do business, and so on and so far. And actually we have noticed that technology has an absolute control over our lives, because we work and communicate with each other online every day and every moment. And there are some advantages, some useful advantages. And at first, the first advantage that I want to talk about is the advantage of using technology at school. Given that we are
students. Come on. And there are some students, they're specifically learning with technology,
the
university online, the virtual university.
Oh, yes.
And by the way, I'm saying hi to them, respect to all them. Frankly, it's a very nice university. How they're learning is very systematic, frankly speaking. And those are what we call the university online, on the online university, virtual university.
Yeah,
I'll let you keep it up.
You know that computers, mobile phones, and internet are being used at school so as to help students to improve their levels and also to boost their morale to learn. And also, at first, we have the individual learning. Individual learning, because we know that students are, we're not the same. We're different. I mean, the way that we are learning is not the same. The way that we're understanding stuff is not the same. And with technology, with the internet, you can learn by your own speed. I mean, you will learn easily. You will understand stuff, by yourself. And I think that's something also very important. But also, we have visualized education, and this is something very, very important, and it is becoming more and more popular. And we can do it with some subjects like mathematics, biology, or even geography. Because when you have your computer, you have the map and stuff like that, you will understand easily. Yes, easily. And also, icing on the cake, we know that with technology, with computers and internet and stuff like that, you can, learn. And when you are at home, no need to go at school. And that's something very important for the disabled student. For the disabled student, that's something very important for them. And also we have the advantages for, you know, the politician during the elections. Yes, during the elections. Yes, guys like Mr. Mar. You're right. Guys like Mr. Mar, they use, you know, the internet, they use technology so as to show people what they want to do and also to, so as to ask people to vote for them. And that's something very important. But we also have, you know, business. Now business is so easy, you know, you can have, you know, the only stuff that you have to do is just to show your product and people will see it, and if they want, they will buy it. You know, that's something also very important for the advantages. And there are lots of advantages, I'm telling you.
Ladies and gentlemen, as you can notice, right, with the technology, we really have a great number of advantages, I'm telling you, a great number. And in every domain that you take, technology is useful right over there. A while Musa has mentioned it in transport, in the trade, you know, in education. So wherever you go, you can see that technology is extremely important right over there, because it helped them, you know, achieve a great number of things and easily. I'm telling you, because remember, we do have what you call old technologies and new technologies, and we don't really have to forget that. Here, we really have our own technology. I'm used to saying it. By the way, I'm saying hi to Mr. John, my African civilization teacher. Really, he has taught us a great, important things, I'm telling you, very great things. And from that, I would like to take just one part where he was saying that in Africa, we really had our technologies because our forefathers and our foremothers, they succeeded in covering themselves by using technology. Yes. Because they had taken some, like, the flower of the tree, and they make some kind of boo-boo. Yes. And they cover themselves. They did it with when they needed shoes. That's exactly what they did. Yes. So this is part of technology. Yes. Because they succeeded in satisfying themselves by using their own experience in order to make some great things. So this is also technology. We really don't have to forget that.
Bad and creating a heart also.
Yeah, that's technology.
Yes, and creating some arrows.
Yeah, some arrows. Okay. Come on.
The technology.
Yeah.
The technology has existed long before.
Long before the arrival.
In Africa.
Yeah.
Okay. And hi, Mr. John.
Mr. John, doing great. My hi to you. So from now on, the floor is to be given to Mrs. Zara.
I work on three domains. The risk, we can have it in attention behavior. Second, we have health issues, and then temptation. Inattention behavior, how? I will simply take the example of my own family. You know, family, we have harmony on families. After the dinner, people use it to discuss such kind of stuff. But now it tends to disappear. Why? Because of the new technology that we have. For instance, WhatsApp. Instead of discussing now, after the dinner, all of us, we focus on our mobile phone, maybe on WhatsApp, Instagram, Twitter, all such kind of stuff. And then the harmony disappears. We all are focusing on our mobile. Even to tell you good night, I tell it to you on mobile phone. Even to tell you, give me some water, I tell it to you on the WhatsApp. And this is really sad, you know. And talking about the health issues, you know, spending a lot of time looking at mobile phone or computer can give us some troubles of eyes or some troubles of maybe, I don't know, it can give us some health problems, you know, because we can have some headache because of that, and other diseases that are may not, that we all know, you know. And also temptation. You know, internet is not, technology is not only, how can I say, made up of internet, but internet is part and parcel of technologies, and everything that we see in internet, sometimes we try to do it again, we try to imitate it, and in a very bad way. It's not all the youth that are concerned, but a part of them, and the major part of them are sometimes they are influenced by the impact of internet, and this is something that we can avoid. I think that.
I mean, who is to be blamed? Youth to themselves or their parents? I mean, their life givers.
According to me, I will not blame the parents because their parents, they are just human beings. They are not God. They cannot be everywhere. Nowadays, if you see a youth that is well educated, somehow it's thanks to his parents. But in another, it's thanks to Allah because it's only Allah who can help us to well educate our children, you know. Because a parent cannot be everywhere with his child. And he may not know what his child is doing on internet. For instance, I can take my mobile phone, tell to my parents that I am doing some researches. They will think for sure I am doing researches. And I go elsewhere looking at things that I do not have to look.
Okay.
There, who to blame? Parent or child?
Child, certainly.
For sure.
But also, that does not mean, or let's say that should not mean that parents should always put their children at a disposal of to use technology without looking after them. What I mean by that is, from time to time, even though you cannot do it every time, every moment, everywhere, but at least from time to time, you need to check the mobile phone of your child and see what she or he is doing from there. You see, just like check and see some of his messages or those kind of stuff in order to make sure that your child is using technology in a very positive way.
Yes, of course.
Do you have something to say about this, Musa?
But before that, I want to say a very important quote that Relish said about technology. He said that we become a people unable to comprehend the technology we invent.
Can you repeat, please?
We are. We have become a people unable to comprehend the technology we invent. Okay? It means that we created the technology, but we don't know how to really use it. We don't know how to use it. Why? Because we are doing many bad things on that. For example, your question, yes, it's very good to check the phone of your daughter, of your son, to really know what he or she does with her or his phone. Okay? Because it is a control up to the parents to do it. Why? Because there are many temptations, as my sister said. Because you can show things that cannot be shown to another person. Things, private things are unveiled. Meaning that you see, even on WhatsApp, you see sometimes girls, they take a very bad photo in a very bad position, and they post it, and many people see it. How many thousand people see it? Nobody knows. But if the picture is posted, it will stay there for one day. I'm not going to say for 24 hours, but one day. And not one day, but it is stored somewhere else. You see? So this is the risk of in the social way. But I want also in the professional, and technology also causes the pollution. Don't forget that. Why? Because with the transportation, the smoke that gets out from the car, it is participating to the pollution of the air.
Yeah.
It's participating in that. And also the nose, and also the rays, the X-rays, some application, and we don't recommend people to be closer to their phones when they sleep, because it gives some diseases.
Yeah, sure.
Okay? And also, if you spend a lot of time on your phone, on your phone or on the laptop, on the computer, you won't have a very good social life. You can see a child being in front of a TV and playing a game during the whole day. It is possible. Why? Because the factory that created the game, what they want is when you play the game, you buy the next version. Okay? So it's a kind of psychological a psychological politic, you see? And also, I want to mention something which is important also. It is the use of Instagram. The use of Instagram, it is something also very, it is something very good, but it is something very bad.
Yeah.
Something very bad, okay? Because Instagram, you want to control the number of people that see your posts. No, it's impossible. Recently, you all have heard a football player. She was with a girl in a room, and they were doing everything they want. And after it was posted on the internet, on the social media. And if something is posted, 1 minute, 30 people can see it. 30 in 1 minute or more. It depends. It depends on the availability of the people. Okay? So, also in education, the applications and the computers, they can make the students be lazy when they learn. Because you can see somebody who doesn't want to go to the university, he or she will say, no, after I will download the course. I will download the course. No problem. No need to move. And also, nobody will read. We have some applications that contains every books that we want. You can, you go, you download it. So you let here the library. And if you let here the library and use the application. Some people can learn with the application or their phone. Some people also can't. Me, I can't. But you know that there are many risks in the social and professional world. And we have some solution on that, but it will be proposed after.
Inshallah, for sure it will be proposed after. Ladies and gentlemen, dear viewers, dear followers of Ucad Leadership TV show, just to remind you that today I'm with my very dynamic cohorts, Mr. Musasi, and I'm also having right here Mrs. Zahara, and last but not least, we have Mariam.
You know, sometimes parents, they have to control their son and their daughters, but they cannot do it all the time. They cannot be here all the time. And being a teenager doesn't mean that you're not an intellectual, that you don't know what you are doing. Sometimes you know what you're doing, but you just do it because you want to do it, right? But I think that if, you know, some people are using internet in the, you know, negative way, it's just because they want to do it. Because nowadays, we know how it works. And you talk about education, the upbringing. Yes, you're right. Because I think that, you know, a bad tree doesn't yield good apples. It means that when the parents is bad, sometimes the, you know, children cannot be, they can't be good. Yes, that's it. And also to talk about the risks, you know, I think the worst is, you know, waste of time. We are wasting our time on the internet. Most of the time commenting on things that are not important, you know, watching videos that are not important for us. Instead of, you know, reading newspapers, instead of reading our books, we all the time, you know, with our cell phone, our mobile phones, you know, talking with, you know, talking about something that are really not important. And also we have isolation. I mean, sometimes you isolated, you in the family, but you're not in because you're not talking with your parents, you're not talking with your, you know, brothers and sisters. Most of the time you are, you know, just talking with your friends and, you know, in the internet. And I think that's something really bad for the society.
Yeah, very important ideas. You've mentioned something very important, which is isolation.
Yeah.
And you know, in our country or in our continent, we do have our own realities. And you have mentioned it a while. For example, every time that we finish to have dinner, then all the family members, we gather, we discuss, we chat, we talk, we laugh, we do everything to, you know, we just enjoy ourselves. But now it is about to disappear. Why? Because of new technologies. Now, instead of chatting with my parents, talking to them, playing with my young brothers and sisters at home, I'd rather take my mobile phone and chatting with a brother whom I even do not know or whom I have never seen.
It happens. Yes.
Yeah.
It happens.
You see?
Yes.
And how can you minimize? How can you? How you might not give a consideration to the one who is closer to you, but you're giving much more consideration to one who is far from you, someone whom you've never seen even. You just say, hi, hello, how are you, on WhatsApp or Messenger or Instagram. Well, that's somehow very useless, I'm telling you. That's somehow very useless. So we do have to have a step back and bring our realities. What I mean is, we have to bring them back and then, be involved in what we were used to doing over the past few years. After dinner, you're playing with, talking with parents, playing with, your young brother and sister. It's more important than what we're doing right now, frankly speaking, right? And I think, ladies and gentlemen, we just have 10 minutes left and we'll have to talk about, maybe within 5 minutes, we'll have to talk to bring some solution. And before giving anyone to you the floor in order to bring some solution, just to remind your viewers that a solution is not a solution, but the fulfillment of the solution is the solution. Whom am I going to give the floor first in order to talk about?
The ladies again.
Yeah, let's give Sarah. What do you think about, the solution that we can have?
Everything that deserves to be done deserves to be well done. And a while ago, talk about something very important, which is education, the most powerful weapon that we have in this world, And as my sister said a while ago, isolation, I will come back to that. It is one thing that is part in the risk of technologies and is something that, how can I say, is very ugly, It is a very ugly thing that is here, isolation. And the solution that I have is that after the dinner, why not to put all the mobile phone on the room, come again, sit, discuss, tell the story that we have. And a while ago, Mr. Musa has mentioned library. Personally, I sometimes think that library is an historical thing. Really, a thing that we have let back. Because now, it's, how can I say? We see it barely, a person that go to library, bring book, read it, and share it with friends, parents, and sisters. We do not have this time. Why? Because of new technologies. As the singer said, we have to take drastic measures on about it. If not, it may destroy our beloved society that we have, the nice society that we built yesterday. We do not have to destroy.
And our today's idioms of the day is to let the cat out of the bag. I repeat, to let the cat out of the bag. It means to reveal a secret. When you let the cat out of the bag, that means that you reveal a secret. For example, I may say, Musa, I really like mafe, but please don't tell it to the others, meaning don't let the cat
out of the bag.
Out of the bag. Okay. What do you think about the solutions?
Okay, I think that everything lays on values. Because here in Africa, we have very immense tradition. Past decades, we used after the dinner to sit together, and our mother or father or our grandfather used to tell story. But now we can have it here. We can have it here in this today, in this world. Because you can have a brother being inside her room and you call her or him, come on, we have dinner. She prefers staying on the phone, chatting with another or somebody else that you have never seen before, rather than coming and eat. It happens everywhere. But for the solution, we have to sensitize. But before sensitizing, we have to have some subjects taught in our schools. Why? Because it will. If you have some people that are prepared, so they will convince some students and some teenagers youth, they will convince them to use the technology and internet and things like that in a positive way. Why? Because we have to have some subject here in the university, a subject where teachers will tell us this is the right way or this is the wrong way. Because teachers are also, you are a teacher, you are an educator. It's not because your father or your mother have to educate you at home. Okay? Also, we have the security. So security, how we can secure the internet, how we can secure things. For example, if somebody has a bank account, the bank account can be hacked. Okay? They will have free access to the bank, and they can take your money.
Very good, very good, very okay. good.
So
very
this
good.
Is something to avoid, cyber criminality.
Yes.
So what I have to say in one word is we have to change the minds. We have to see again our values, because we have African values. And if you have African values, we are not allowed to do some things that are bad, because everything lays on the imitation. We want to imitate Westerners. Appointment.
Excellent.
And we imitate them. This is why sometimes we do things that are not with adequation with our society.
Yes, I just want to say that when you know who you are, you will know what to do with the internet and stuff like that. Because sometimes it can be very, very bad. But just to know when to use it and how to use it. If you know when to use it and how to use it, that's the solution for me.
Great.
Yes.
Very good solution, I'm telling you. I really appreciate. So ladies and gentlemen, dear viewers, it has been a real pleasure and an honor for each and every one of us to share our little ideas about the given topic, which is youth facing new technologies. And I hope you guys really appreciate it, okay? And then for sure, you'll be having some others and very others broadcast again and again, because this is just the first show. This is just the beginning, right? So we would like also to say thank you to all of our staff, all of our team. From them, we can mention Mr. Ngeran, who is right there behind, Mr. Zico, you know, Mr. Jalo Momodu. We're thanking everybody. And for sure, we are going to welcome all of them right over here with Ucad Leadership TV show. And by the way, also, we're saying hi to, we're saying thank you to Mr. Mar, our teacher, who really helped us every day, I'm telling you. So that was Muhammad Mustafa Jan, your today's course. And as far as I'm concerned, I'm going to give you an appointment next time. Same place, same face, with different English proverbs. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you.